a change gonna come. It's been too hard living, but I'm afraid to die. Cause I don't know what's up there beyond the sky. It's been a long, long time coming, but I know the change is gonna come.
I had been watching with the rest of the country the way in which this 12-year-old boy, Tamir Rice, here in Cleveland, had been murdered by the police for wielding a toy gun that they mistook for being real. It was outrageous and infuriating to read the reports afterwards where they had put the blame squarely on the victim and talked about the way in which the toy gun had the safety orange tip removed.
The larger conversation in America right now is who's safe and who is unsafe. And so by removing that color orange, right, we ask ourselves, what is safety like without it?
You know, there's an attraction and a history of how artists and the sacred interact, you know. And I think we call it social practice in 2015, 18, you know. But we've always done that. That's always been a part of practice, is like, how do we depict the sacred, and how do we play with the sacred in paradoxical ways that get people catalyzed into a different kind of accountability.
Miss Rice is very protective of Tamir's name, so the fact that she even allowed anybody, including myself, to create work around it really shows to her evolution and maturity as a leader, as a mother, and as an activist.
As an artist, I often focus on the minor object as a way to tell a bigger story. And I thought about how horribly poetic it was to be talking about how the removal of a color led to the removal of a person of color. And I think that one of the things that was really important in this close dialogue with spaces was that there was a real push that Cleveland tragedy needed a Cleveland response as well, and so that was also able to kind of broaden the scope of the project and kind of decentralize it from being something that is just seen as being authored, but seeing as being kind of initiated and inclusive of people who have been thinking about these concerns for a long, long time. So artists who I've been working close with since the beginning, like Rafiq Washington, R.A. Washington, and then people who I've more recently come into contact with, like Amanda King and Shooting Without Bullets, Carmen Lane and Amber Ford. And so I don't think about the project without thinking about them, their involvement as well, and the involvement of Miss Samaria Rice, Tamir's mother.
And so I really wanted to show how Black women are at this intersection of state-sanctioned violence, of gender discrimination. And so I wanted to have a show that specifically addressed the intersecting oppressions of race, gender, and socioeconomics in the context of the contemporary Black women and movement building.
The objects on the photographs are things that have been mistaken for guns, and the spaces represent the situations that may happen in the future. I think this work functions in a way to provoke thought on the things that people carry that we think are ordinary, but then can presume to be dangerous if carried by a person of color because they have been easily mistaken for weapons by the police.
So, you know, I was really interested in the idea of erasing narratives that have been played over and over again. So, you know, I made a video that kind of removed the altercation with the cops and allowed for Tamir to just continue playing. I made a bunch of audio splices where Timothy McGinty, the prosecutor, was saying things that I would rather him say than the things he did say. You know, and just hitting on that line where the facts weren't necessarily as important as using those people as like a dual reality.
As a participating artist, it got me thinking about the environment itself and what has happened here that has contributed to the environment that put Tamir at risk.
One of the pieces that I think was donated at the very beginning of the process was a children at play sign that's in the shape of a little kid, plastic, and with the arms outstretched, like a gingerbread man or something. And to see that, one thinks about it as being just kind of like one of those objects that you see, you know, in like school zones and places like that. But then when you see it in the context of something that's about Tamir, it means something totally different.
There was a coalition of local pastors that refused to come up with a plan of action on how to support publicly what has happened, you know, to Tamir Rice and his family. So I think there are people's, you know, there are fears about kind of backlash, about political impact, that's more about the self or, you know, another kind of work that you're doing versus this happened to someone in our community, this happened to somebody's child in our community, and what are our responsibilities as community members.
That's true.